Today we're going to discuss supervised circuits in a fire alarm. I'm going to try to show you how they operate and how it's applied to a couple of conventional zone fire alarm panels. The principles of supervising a circuit, though, can apply also to the notification circuits, and some of the circuitry will operate the same way for ground fault detection. So I'll show you a couple of diagrams first, and then we'll demonstrate how it works on actual fire alarm panels. This is an overly simplified supervised circuit, something you might use in an alarm panel. This is our main power supply here, and we have resistor divider networks here and here through the circuits. And the way this works is this is internal in the panel, and it's just going to set up the reference voltages for our zone to operate. So based on these values and our voltage, there's our 17 volt reference and a 1.5 volt reference. So as long as our zone voltage is in between these numbers, the system will be normal. The other divider network would set up our input when we're in normal condition at 2.4 volts. And if you were to put a meter across the terminals going out to the smoke detectors, you'd read about 21.5 volts. The way an alarm occurs, let's say for instance, we activated a pull station here or a heat detector, that's going to be a short right across the end of line resistor. So you're going to measure 0 volts at the panel with your digital meter. That's going to change the input voltage to these comparators to 23.5 volts using Ohm's law to figure this all out. So now the input here is higher than the reference. So that turns on this comparator and you have a system alarm. Now let's see what happens when we activate a smoke detector. What you'll see, it's not going to be a direct short. It's going to draw some additional current and act like a resistor. So what'll happen then is our zone voltage, if you put your meter across it, is going to be about 6 volts with that added resistance, which is in parallel with your end of line resistor. That's going to change our input voltage to the comparators to 18 volts, which is still larger than 17, so the alarm becomes active. Now let's see what happens if we get an open circuit on the system, either through a broken wire or a device gets removed. Here we got a broken wire, and that's going to cause a system trouble. If you're at the fire panel and you put your meter across the outputs, you're going to read about 24 volts. And our input voltage to the comparators is now 0 volts, which is less than the 1.5 volts, which makes this comparator turn on and activate the system trouble bus. Now that you've seen how the current flow through the zone can affect the voltage at the terminals and how the panel operates, we can actually demonstrate this on a couple panels. But first, remember, you can use the same method on an addressable system that has monitor modules, maybe set up as a zone or even monitoring just a couple points. The voltage at the monitor module will vary depending on whether it's in trouble or an alarm. To help illustrate how a supervised circuit operates, we have 2 meters here. The one on the right is set to DC volts and it's connected in parallel across the zone. The one on the left is set to current and is connected in series with its variable resistor. We can determine at what points the zone will go into alarm and trouble. How this operates would also apply to a notification circuit and even a monitor module on an addressable system. Let's watch how the meters are affected as we reduce the resistance across the zone. The current will increase on this meter and the voltage will decrease on this meter per Ohm's law. At some point, the zone will go into alarm. We'll start by turning this down slowly while watching for that zone to activate. And at some point, we're going to get that alarm light. Once that occurs, these will be the measurements which represent at which point the alarm initiates. And there are the readings. Now we can slowly increase the resistance to find the point at which the zone will indicate a trouble. Voltage should increase and current will decrease per Ohm's law. Slowly turning this down, and we'll get a trouble, and that's the limit for zone supervision. This is an FC72 main board, and it's wired to a smoke detector, heat detector, and a pulse station. The normal zone voltage across an end-of-line resistor is 21.8 on this panel, And if we measure the other one, we'll read a little bit less because of the additional current draw of the smoke detector. The more smoke detectors, the more current draw. Let's see how an activated smoke detector affects the voltage at the terminals. The zone is in alarm, and our voltage measurement with the smoke detector is 5 volts. That's your indication you're looking for a smoke detector and alarm. Don't reset your system until after you've located that smoke detector and serviced it. Once you are ready to reset, just hold the reset for a couple seconds and it will restore to normal. Activating a pull station will put a short on the zone. We'll expect to read 0 at the panel. Measuring across the terminals, you'll see that it is 0 volts. That's how you know you're looking for a pull station, a heat detector, or a short in the wiring. You need to resolve the short before resetting. It'll just go right back into alarm if you don't. This is a Fire Control Instruments CLP, conventional fire alarm panel. For this test, we disconnected our notification circuits, and it's got 4 zones as you can see here. You'll see there's a trouble on zone 2. Your first step is to set your meter to DC voltage, measure the voltage across that zone. You'll see it's 29 volts. You can compare that against the other zones which are not in trouble, which all seem to read around 26.5 volts, give or take. Next, switch your meter to ohms. Remove your circuit from the panel. Get a resistance measurement, and you'll see that's in the mega ohms, which is essentially an open circuit. If you're unsure what the resistance should be, what you can do, remove a zone that's not in trouble, measure the resistance of that circuit, and you'll have that as a comparison. When we measure a zone that was in normal condition, we see that it was about 3.9 kiloohms. Make sure you record what the normal zone voltage should have been and what the end-of-line resistor value should be. While troubleshooting, you discovered a smoke detector had been removed. Reinstalling that device should restore the system to normal. If you have a zone and alarm, you still start with your meter on DC voltage, measure the voltage across that zone and alarm. In this case, we're measuring about 0 volts. If you compare it to another zone, we should have about 26.3 volts. So we know there's a short because you can't read voltage across a short. What you're going to be looking for is an activated pull station, heat detector, or perhaps even a short in the wiring. You'll need to inspect the devices on the zone, look for an activated heat detector or a pull station. This manual station has been activated. You can tell because the handle's down and this piece protrudes from the bottom. Before you can reset your fire alarm panel, you need to reset this pull station. This is how it looks in normal. The handle's back up, nothing's protruding, so you can reset your fire panel. When you're back at the fire panel, measure your zone. The voltage should be normal now, which it is. And now you can reset your fire alarm panel to restore that zone to normal condition. Here's another example of a zone and alarm. First thing to do is measure for voltage. When you measure it, we'll see we have 5 volts, so that's not a short. It's not a shorted wire or a pull station, most like a smoke detector or a thermal detector. Do not disconnect the wires and check for ohms because that'll reset the detector. Once you locate the smoke detector, now you can either service it or replace it as needed. But had you removed the wires at the panel, that light would not have been on and you would have been unable to find it. So remember, do not remove the wires if you're looking for a smoke detector.